What's up? This is Nick V from the Baka Boyz, also known as The Violator, also now known as Bob Dope. Right now, everything is in the house, in the box. It be abled in live for the most part. I got rid of all my outboard gear, drum machines, just everything. Just now, it's all abled in live internal. I produce multi-genres, hip-hop, everything from hip-hop to house to trap. Now I'm into Jersey club shit right now. Anything goes, and I could do everything with Ableton. Once I figured out back in 2008 that I could make a house track and I could make a hip-hop track on Ableton, I just totally got rid of all my gear, like Craigslist, quickly got rid of everything. So wow, stepping back to the early 90s would be remixes for Cypress Hill, Far Side, worked with Ice Cube and Yo-Yo. Volume 10 was probably our biggest production in like 92 93, with Pistol Grip Pump. Tons of remixes for everything from Offspring to now. I just did OT Genesis remix for Coco, and Ray Shrimmer remix for No Type. It's just run the whole gamut, and I'm trying to lock in a remix for this Hozier record, Take Me to Church. Probably the Volume 10 record. The reason why I say that is because it was a record that we did not really want to make. It was kind of a simple hip-hop, like West Coast hip-hop record, and at that point in time when we were producing, we did not want to sound like anything of the West Coast. We were so like on DJ Mug stuff and East Coast style, and that record basically showed me that simplicity works, and keep it simple, keep it simple. And that's probably, I'm still struggling with keeping it simple, honestly. Heavy influences, Quincy Jones, of course, Dr. Dre, Timberland, Egyptian Lover, heavy influence, Tony G and Julio G back in the day, and Kraftwerk, love them cats. These days, Diplo is heavy right now. He's nothing he can't do, he can touch anything right now. Really, really loving Cashmere Cat. He's like probably my favorite of 2014. Guy named Hoochie, this young kid out of, I think he's out of the UK. He's like 17, 18 years old, and he just continues to drop massive, massive tunes. Hudson Mohawk is another young kid that I'm really, really peeping out his style. So those are a few influences. Collaborations. I just collaborated with a producer, DJ out of Texas, M Squared, on that No Type remix. He sent me what he had on the remix, and he's like, "Yo, I tapped out on this one. Can you do something to it?" So I took it, kind of reflipped it, and added my flavor to it. And so that was a pretty cool and easy collaboration. Fucking with Clayton William as well from the Bay Area, new R&B dudes that we're starting to work with as well. A guy named Christian, a guy named Guy James. We just did a song with Too Short for the Baka Boyz project. And a gentleman named Thurs, who signed to Red Bull. And another cat out of Orlando that we're trying to sign to the Baka Boyz brand name. His name is Palmer Reed. So there's a few cats that we're collaborating with right now. Come and catch it. Respected in the morning, but naked. It could be Tim, it could be Pharrell, Quincy Jones, probably on top of those cats would probably be the ultimate, because his incredible knowledge in the last 50 years in music, everything from Thriller, and even before that, I think he was a music coordinator for Count Basie or one of these cats way back in the big band era. So he's got a tremendous amount of knowledge as far as music is concerned, and he's just like an orchestrator. basically. You get to sit back, relax, guitar player, drummer, bongos, just direct everybody. He's worked with everybody, so Quincy Jones probably above and above all of them. Tough one. I guess don't ever stop, you know. You're gonna get turned away several times before you get a yes, or before you get somebody to, you know, actually give you a flag, you know what I mean, just give you an opportunity. So don't stop, you know, just keep on doing it. Create your own sound. I guess don't try to sound like anybody else, because once you do that, you're just a bad carbon copy, you know, of these cats that you're trying to sound like. And I think every producer falls into that. You know, there's a difference between being influenced and actually jacking somebody's entire style. You will never ever be that original DNA of this person that you're trying to be like. We've gone through that ourselves with, you know, wanting to sound like Mugs and, you know, getting to a certain point, but it's always like the cheap Mugs sound. So it's never really your sound. Create your own style, your own sound, so you don't sound like anybody else. So when that beat drops, it's like, who the fuck produced this shit? Who did this? That's what you want. That's the kind of reaction you want from the record. What's cracking? This is Nick V from the Baka Boyz. You're watching Lab Life Pro, because we pro and we in the lab and we live this life already.